So I think that's going to be a very interesting dynamic to play. You know, one other thing about McCarthy is Trump condemned all these Republicans during the course of my interview. You know, Pence, McCarthy, Barr, you know, his former cabinet secretaries, all of them. But he did praise Marjorie Taylor Greene and said she was terrific and she had fought for him and stood for him. And then he added, and Kevin hasn't treated her properly. Kevin hasn't treated her properly. So there's some real bitterness that Trump, it surprised me, has towards Kevin McCarthy, despite the way McCarthy has stood by him.
Well, you know, you haven't, we haven't talked, and I don't know what your conversations with Kevin McCarthy have been, but it is interesting, though. It's hard to talk to somebody off the record who hasn't written a book that doesn't say that Kevin McCarthy isn't one of their great sources. He leaks like a sieve, wants everybody to know he has contempt for Donald Trump, attacks Donald Trump off the record, and I was struck by the fact that he let it out very quickly on January the 6th about the private phone call they had where he was shouting at Donald Trump and swearing at him. It's very interesting that it seems McCarthy is still trying to do this, as Dan Rather would say, Texas two-step. But you can never do that with Donald Trump. You're either all in or you're all out.
He's doing the Chris Christie.
I mean, McCarthy looks at a situation where the majority of his conference, the majority of those House Republicans are all in for Donald Trump, and maybe a majority of that majority are truly in. I mean, like, believe everything. They're part of the cult. And so McCarthy is the leader of that conference. And, you know, his vision of leadership is doing the will of those that elected him leader. And there you are. I think that's why you see what you've seen.
Hey, John, it's Jonathan Lemire. Good morning and congrats on the book. I want to talk to you about some of your new reporting about something that was bandied out a lot during the Trump years, the 25th Amendment, which, of course, allows for the potential removal of the president if he is deemed incapacitated physically or perhaps mentally for office. And you have some reporting here on conversations held by some of the most influential cabinet members, including Secretary Mnuchin, the Treasury Secretary, and Secretary of State Pompeo. Walk us through what you found. How real was this?
So I learned rock-solid sourcing on this. I learned that Steven Mnuchin had a conversation with Mike Pompeo on the evening of January 6th. And I learned that Mnuchin had several conversations about the 25th Amendment, and further, that Mike Pompeo actually asked for a legal analysis of the 25th Amendment and how it would work. The idea quickly was jettisoned. You had on January 7th, cabinet members resign. You had DeVos resign. You had the Labor Secretary, Elaine Chao, resign. It quickly became apparent that the 25th Amendment was not going to work. It wouldn't be quick enough. It would be subject to legal challenges, et cetera. But in those hours after the riot, there were high-level conversations about this. And here is the fascinating detail about work that I found out as working on this book. I reached out to both Mnuchin and to Pompeo over and over and over and over again, and they would not say anything to me on the record. Did they favor it? Did they not favor it? Did they discuss it? Did they not discuss it? Until, as I was just about to go to press, I had one final telephone interview with Donald Trump, and I brought all of this up with him and said, you know, why is it that these guys won't even deny it? They won't even, you know, if you say it's not true, I mean, why won't they deny it? And then within a couple of hours after that interview ended, I suddenly got a call from one of Pompeo's top aides.
Hey, thanks so much for watching our YouTube channel. You can follow up on today's top stories and breaking news or catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.